Alright, we're back for round two. It seems our opponent is playing some form of Overrun Mass Polymorph token deck. He's gonna be playing first, so that definitely puts me at a disadvantage. But, yeah, I think I'm gonna keep this hand. I'm going to be drawing, first of all. Then I have a cantrip that serves as a defender. Then I can gain incremental advantage over with all my survival caches. The problem is really going to be that he's going to create a lot of tokens, and I can't destroy them. At this point, I'm just gonna go for play Wall of Omens and just cantrip my way into good stuff. So next turn I can play the Crossroads, another Wall of Omens. That's actually kind of important. The main thing I'm going to want to do is get to some removal. Just in case he does polymorph. Though it doesn't look like that's going to be happening for me right now. Right, so if he were to do the over the stampede, he would get plus. He'd basically be overrunning right now, and it would be 6, 3, 3, 3. So, how much would I take? I'd take at least. I'll take 9. So, do I have anything else I'd want? Picking Needle is kind of bad here. I think I'm better off running out survival cash, so I can at least draw a card now than later. As later, I probably won't be able to. And I just hope he doesn't have a land and. Oof. I guess it's perfectly fine if he does have the Stampede. It's not fine that he has Mass Polymorph. Oof. Oh, I guess. Oh, okay. See what happened there. I'm basically just gonna have to O-ring the Ulamog. Don't really care about it. Okay, so he has Unified Will, Into the Royal, Skittering Invasions. Not something I worry about too much. Okay, cast. Right. Gonna have to run out the O-ring. He may not be able to be destroyed, but he can be exiled. And then, one of the Wall of Omens. Really would be nice to actually get some removal here, but gotta make do sometimes. Okay, so we're gonna see what's gonna happen here. This is making the whole overwhelming stampede seem pretty overwhelming. Okay. So I can. He will probably unified will whatever I run out. So question is, does he have it, or and if he does have it, what do I run out first? I'm gonna have to run out the pride mate first. And then survival cache. Oh, didn't have it. Okay, gonna. Dang. Missed my opportunity. A lot of dead cards right now. Oof. Let's see. Pretty much, I just had to, like, hope that he doesn't overwhelm me. Which, okay. So, what kind of damage am I looking at here? 6, 12, 27. Okay. 27. I could block. They have trample, so it's not necessarily like a great idea. If I block 9, I still take 12, 17, 23. That puts me in a very poor spot. There's very little I could do in that regard. But it's better not to chump with Pride Mate at this point, because he's gonna get pumped next turn. And that'll allow me to actually just kill a token instead. Don't get to draw, but not huge deal. It's pretty overwhelming. Gotta admit to that. Always yield. It was the yielding. Kind of, it failed me. If he has a counter for Sun Titan, then I'm pretty screwed. So he doesn't have it. Bring back Marsh Flats. Now it's pretty much I just gotta lay low for a little bit. If he has the stampede, I'm dead. If he doesn't, he has the stampede, so. Pretty bad, like that was really just bad beats. Couldn't do much in against that. Want more removal. Really not a lot I can bring in. At the very least, where is it? Consuming Vapors is still good, even if he does make tokens. It basically just removes more, because his tokens are still high damage, and it also gets around Ulamog's indestructibility clause. Now the hope is just basically that he doesn't have all of that right off the bat. Elspeth is actually pretty dead in this matchup because he has trample. So it's just better having the third duress.